Hello everyone, this is Ali Reza. Today we will start with our graph schema to one line of code in tick graph, few lines of code initialize, and then update GUI and get editor scheme. So let's start with get editor scheme. We say dark scheme equals to GUI style utils dot dark scheme. Well, we have a light skin there for our light skin. Okay, that's our get editor scheme. Now, inside initialize, before I assign the nodes, I will check if nodes equals to null. Because if nodes is not equal to null, I don't want to reset it. After that, we say if nodes.any, then we say for each inside nodes var node, we simply call node.initialize. So before this, we checked if the nodes are null, then we created, so this won't yell at us about any null point exception anymore. If you have any nodes, then initialize the nodes for me, please. And we initialize the selection nodes, and then we say get editor scheme. Okay? Tick is really simple. We say related graph dot tick graph. And I should check if related graph does not equal to null. Not bad to check it. Okay, now comes the magic. Update graph GUI. We say if. Well, let me see where to start from. Selection node does not equal to null, and selection node dot count equals to 1. Then we say selected node equals to selection node of 0. Okay. Then we say if nodes dot any, not add, any, we go again and say for each inside nodes var node, and we say node dot, and we have something to do that we don't have yet, and we say draw GUI, and we send in the event that we have. So at sign event, and we will also send in our vrect. Okay, and well, there will be more code in here regarding of dragging and selection, and then making some connections. But one thing I want, before I forgot, we say if event dot type equals to layout with I'm not sure which, where is the difference between these two. I am using the capital one, okay? And then we say show properties equals to true. So we will only show the properties for the nodes when the GUI stuff is going for the layout, not for the repend time, okay? After that, we have the process events that accepts the event and the vrect. After that, we say editor utility dot set dirty this. This line will cause our scriptable object to update itself every frame when we are doing tricks to it. For example, if we are making a connection and we want the nodes to update themselves, this is where the scriptable object says the to the unitator that, hey, I need to serialize myself, basically. And it's inside editor utility namespace. So right off the bat, you will understand that scriptable objects are one-way asset inside runtime. When you are in runtime, scriptable objects are read-only. You can't put stuff inside the scriptable objects at runtime. But at editor time, because you have access to editor utility.set30ds on a scriptable object, you can write to the scriptable objects. So if you want to think about it, scriptable objects are like any database that you have one application to read and write to it, and then another application that only can read the database. That is the type of the scriptable object. The application that can read and write to the scriptable object is Unity Editor. But at game time, when you build your game, that is when we call runtime, at runtime, the application are only reading the scriptable objects. So basically, scriptable objects are not a good asset or not a good type to keep track of game changes. So it's not a good type for saving your game, unfortunately. Anyway, now that we have part of our update GUI done, now we need to add this thing to node schema. But if we come to node schema and do this stuff time and time and time again and add to the node schema, node schema will become a very big file. I think it would be near 1,000 lines of code. So what I want to do is inside here, I will generate a class and I will call it node schema GUI. Okay. And I will say public virtual void draw GUI that accepts an event, and I call it event, and a rect as view rect. But I will go back to node schema, and on top I had this public partial class that section without inheritance. Okay, I will copy it and I will come back and I will paste it here. Because they are sitting in same namespace, I don't need to change the namespaces or anything. But now you see that partial here and here is not deprecated anymore. It's being used. What is a partial class? Is a class that is dissected into multiple .cs files. The compiler would put every one of these dissected files into one final single IL file. But now we are able to dissect our node schema into multiple files, and this will cause it to be much more readable. For example, when I want to work on the node GUI, then I know that, hey, look for the GUI. If I want, for example, to work on the comments, then I will look for a file that has the comment name, or the connections, or the help, properties, the status, output, input, anything, event. So I will have multiple files that are all related to one IL class type, but it's much more readable. And you will understand what I'm talking about when you see this thing finished, just the draw GUI. So let's start with it. We say our view rect, and I don't have it. You kidding me? Node schema. What did I call it? Lower V. Make it capital V. Thank you. Oh no. F2. Q. capital. So we say our vRect equals to the sent-in vRect. Then we say if parent graph equals to null, then return, because we don't have anything to do. If we don't have any parent graph, we don't want to draw the GUI on the graph, blah blah blah. Then we say node scheme equals to editor GUI layout dot is not layout utility dot is pro scheme. This tells us that if you're using this thing here, basically inside your edit preferences, are you using editor scheme professional or personal? So is pro scheme is equals to professional. Okay, so if you are pro scheme, then we want the parent graphs dot dark scheme. Otherwise, we want the parent graphs light scheme. Okay, so now we can use the light or dark scheme of our parent graph based on the layout that we have inside Unity. After that, we say GUI style, node style equals to node scheme dot get style of node default. And right now I want to check it to be sure that I have it or not. So where was it? Inside utility, not here. Inside utility here, GUI style, and for sure I don't have it. Okay, so I will say style equals to new GUI style and use field initializer, the name equals to that for time being. Okay, and right at the end we say styles dot add our style before I forget anything. So we have a node default there. And another thing is that I'm not sure if I'm assigning the node scheme or not. So I will go to hitting Control B, not here, sorry, node scheme. Okay, Control B, and I'm checking if I am assigning it to anything. And rest assured, I'm not. Okay, so, well, I'm dumb. I'm assigning it right on top. Okay, so now that I have made sure that I have the GUI style, so at least it doesn't yell at me, then we say if related node is a base, is actually the base node, so if it's the node, no, actually I want something that I don't have, BT base node. So it's about behavior trees. So I will say to do change style on behavior trees. Okay, when we have the behavior trees, we want to change the style based on the status of the node in the behavior tree. Then we say node boundary equals to node rect that we already have, and node rect is being defined here. Node schema, node rect. Okay, so at the start we say the node boundary equals to node rect. Then we say if outputs dot any. Okay, we say node boundary dot height plus equals to 11. So if you have any outputs, we add 11 pixels to our node boundary. Then we say if inputs dot any, we want to do two things now. We say node boundary, where is that? Dot y minus equals to 11, and then again node boundary dot height plus equals 11. And I said plus equals. Okay? Now, to show this, I will put a line down here and we say GUI dot box node boundary with nothing in it. Let's just compile it. Go to Unity. This guy had a test node, remember? And now I get null reference exception again. And I can't see anything. On draw GUI, I think. Why am I getting on draw GUI? A null point exception. I think I know what's going on and I hate it. No, I'm not sure. Let's see what can be null here. Outputs. So we say if no, I say outputs does not equal to null, and this shouldn't be the case, but just in case. And this is inputs. Let's see if that was the case. I'm not sure. And I forgot to build. Well, this happens a lot. And I know what's going on here. The thing is that before I implement this guy, you see this parent graph dark scheme, parent graph light scheme. Well, here's the thing that we have to deal with, and I don't see my mouse, for God's sake. Okay. Thank you. Database, this guy. Or actually, this guy is our parent graph, okay? I should implement that hidden code later. But take a look. Dark skin is null. Light skin is null. The thing that is happening is that I told Unity to get them after I created this database. So I need to delete this guy. Delete this guy so that this guy gets refreshed. And now I can create a graph, whatever. And I can create a test node now. And this is your node boundary. Okay? Now, I'm not getting any more null reference because, well, guess what? Parent graph. Now it has type mismatch. And I know what is going on. The thing is that when I'm going into GUI-Sci utility, you see that, no, actually, I'm creating an instance here. GUI skin, create instance. Well, the reason is that I'm referencing an instance inside another instance, and Unity for some reason is not happy about this. And says type mismatch, but in reality it works, and I don't care because this guy is editor only stuff. As long as it is showing properly, then I'm okay. How can I make sure that it's really working? Well, if I get something like this guy, okay, copy it and come down and here paste it. And what's your problem now? I said comma, not M. There we go. And build it. Now if I go back to Unity, you will see this thing change its view. Basically, it should. Test. No, why not? What did I do wrong? Graph view background. Delete the graph. Rebuild everything. Let it enter. Create a graph. Come on. Create the test. And it's not calling it correctly. So if I put anything inside the here, test, build, come back here, it's showing it black. Yeah. So it's not reading it correctly. Did I miss anything? No. I'm creating a new style, node default, adding the style. And what is the problem here now? Is that I'm not reading these two time and time again. Well, instead of this, I can say, where is this? I can say get dark skin this guy should be public now. I'm doing it temporarily because it needs Unity's, you know, basically closing and running again. I don't want to do that. Ah, no, it's not reading it. Why aren't you reading it? So the schema has a dark skin type mismatch. And it's not yelling at me about any missing style. So I know that the style is there, but it's not working. Huh. Wait, I'm dumb. I'm really dumb. I need to say, hey, use the node style for God's sake. Ah. And there we go. Okay, so yeah. Blah. Blasphemy. Okay, so going back. Retrieving our work from graph schema. It was the dark skin. It was working, but I wasn't assigning it. Okay. So I don't need this part. I just need, I will just keep the texture color. Text color, I mean, and I will add some blue to it. And I don't know, some green and blue. Okay. And then inside the schema, yeah, that would work. Build, come back. And now it's not working because it's reading that previous stuff. Test. Now it's working. Okay. And you see that it has no image at all. It's just blasphemy. So, well, I don't need any node style here. I just want to show the boundaries of a node, and it's temporarily, I will comment it later. But yeah, I will come back to this guy later because I have to do stuff later on, not now. So that was our node boundary, finally. Okay. Now, I should check for these null stuff. You say if, no, actually I do it like this. If it's pro, well, I'm thinking about something here. What I'm doing is this. If editor GUI utility dot is pro scheme, then I'm saying node scheme equals to parent graph dot dark scheme. Else I'm saying node scheme equals to parent graph dot light scheme, and I'm not checking for null. So I should say if parent graph dot dark scheme does not equal to null, do this. And if parent graph, and that it would be problematic now. You see where it puts this guy? I want it to be here. Boom. Else if parent graph dot light scheme does not equals to null, then do this. And you see that I lose the ability to convert them to ternary now. It's not allowing me. And what if it's null? Because then this wouldn't work, you know. Well, it would yell at me that, hey, we have a null reference and I don't want this. I don't want this. So I will say equals to node scheme does not equal to null. Do that. Otherwise, to new GUI style. At least this will work. It only will yell at me that, hey, I don't have node default as a warning, not an error. And the script will continue working. So, actually, I can say else parent graph dot dark scheme, parent graph dot don't have that, huh? No. So if I come back here and I make this one public, now I will get access to it here, and I will say public get editor skins, and then return something like that. So at least for one frame we won't see anything, but basically it will update itself the next one. Good. That's been that. Now I should be... Nah, can't convert it to stationary. Okay. So, let's continue. Now, I want to be able to draw stuff. So, I will say if icon equals to null, because later on I will draw icons for my stuff. I will say GUI.box with node-rect and related node.name, node name, and the node style. Okay? Else, we have an icon there. Then I will say GUI.tooltip equals to the show name. Then we will have GUI.box node-rect with no text and node style. So we are drawing the box in both cases. If we have an icon, then we don't want any name. If we don't have icon, then we want the node name to be shown. Okay, that's the difference. And then we say if node-rect dot contains event dot mouse position, we want to do stuff, and at the end we want to say GUI dot box new rect of node rect dot x plus node rect dot width divided by 2 minus node rect dot height divided by 2 plus 2. That's the x. The y will be our node rect dot y plus 2. Our width will be node rect dot height minus 4, and the height is node rect dot height minus 4. The content that we want to show is the icon itself, and then we have this icon style that, if you remember right now, icon style is where is that? Somewhere around here. Icon style is an empty style, okay? So, what did I do here is just first draw a box with the name or without the name. Then if the mouse is inside the rect, I will add something here for the label as well. Let's do it. GUI.label new rect on node boundary this time dot x minus 120 minus node boundary dot width divided by, come on, divided by 2, that's our x. The width will be node boundary dot y plus node boundary dot height. Then we want 120 by 20. The content would be GUI.tooltip, and the thing as our scheme would be dot get a style of tooltip, and I hope I spelled it like this. Yeah. Okay. So if I move my mouse inside the node, I will show a tooltip like this. And finally, I will draw the node boundary. Now, there are things here that I'm not assigning. For example, show name. Okay. Let's go to our test node schema. If I find it. Inside nodes, inside test node schema. And I need to do public override initialize. After we call the base, we want to say show name equals test, for example. Okay? And what else am I using here? So from the top, node name, show name, and the icon. Okay, that should work. Now let's build and come back to Unity. And this is what we get. This time, this test is the tooltip. No, not the tooltip, it's the name of the content, okay? And this is our boundary, and at the same time, I'm drawing two boxes inside each other because test node has no input, no outputs. But let's see what happens if I, inside test node, I say inputs.add new schema, and that's it, build. It won't work until I create another test node. And what's wrong? Yeah, there we go. You see, this boundary is now bigger than this boundary because I'm adding 11 pixels on top for the input, okay? And if I comment this guy by saying outputs.add new schema output, again, you won't see any changes. Did I build it? No. You won't see any changes unless I create the nodes. So test, and that's it. Okay. So you see now, it's like this, the test will show on top, but instead of having this small area, I have a bigger area that 11 pixels of it is the place for showing our output connections. Okay? So delete the graph because I didn't implement the clearing the graph right now. Anyway. So that's that. And let me show both input and output. And if I find my utilities now, GUI style utility, and inside the GUI style utility, I need to find this guy. So why can't I? Oh yeah, here, Control V. Okay, so for this guy, the normal equals to, and I forgot the comma here. Oh, come on. Normal equals two. Thank you. The background equals to resources dot node back normal. And I don't have it yet. Text color equals to graph utils, graphic utils dot color from 256, and this is 255 255 255 and 128, so it has alpha in it. After that, we say border, and I forgot a comma there, border equals to new rect offset of 6, 6, 6, 6, And font size equals to 11. Alignment equals to text anchor, middle center or upper center? Upper center. And finally, stretch width equals to true. Okay? So, now I need node back normal. And node back normal. Okay. Going into my resource, if I find it. I want a public static read-only texture 2D that equals to graphic utility utils dot load texture of this. And I don't assign any width and height because by default, if you recall, the width and height was 512 by 512, okay? So I'm using that, but I need this image now. So inside this guy, Alt Enter, inside resources, add existing file, and I will go back inside my R&D node editor, DLL solution node here, resources, and I will find that node back normal. I will give you these guys later, but for time being, bear with me. So node back normal, open. It will add to the project here. I will go to properties, and I will write here assign embedded resources, and I control shift S. Okay. Now if I build this guy, finally, you will be able to see something semi-close to a node, and I didn't. Well, delete the graph, create a new graph, and test. There we go. Now you see the difference. The thing that is showing inside this box is the node rect. The thing that is showing inside the other box outside is the node boundary. Node boundary will compensate for the inputs and outputs. Okay? Now that we saw what is the job of node boundary, I can finally come here and comment this guy. I will keep it around because every now and then I had to take a look and work with this guy later. But let's save it, let's recompile it, let's go back to Unity and let it show its magic. And this is our node. So this is the node body, okay? You don't see anything on top, you don't see anything on bottom, and we don't have any comments here. Why is that one? Didn't I say? Oh, because the icon is null, okay? So if I had any icon, I would see the icon. So let's build the icon. Why not? So that we can see the whole thing here. So for our test node, where is my test node schema? You kidding me? I don't have any resource for that. You are kidding me. I had something. Yeah, I had it. Okay. So, coming back to our solution, inside my resource, I will add one more. And that, and I will call it test node. And the texture's name is test. Now, I need you, but okay, inside resources, and it won't work like this, would it? It would be too good. Okay. Add existing file. Go to my R&D and then node 5 and there and there and there and resources. I have something called test here somewhere. And I will show you how did I develop these guys. It's not a big deal. This is a simple text with some effects on it, basically. So here's the test. Embed resources. And now inside my test node schema, I can say icon equals to resource dot test node. Okay. Now build. It won't show up right now, because remember, whenever you are creating a node, that's when you are instantiating the initialize. Okay. But if I generate a new test node, take a look. I have the icon right in the middle, and if I move my mouse, you will see the tooltip below. This empty section between the tooltip and the node boundary is the place that we will draw our output. Okay? So I have this guy here. This guy didn't have icon before, so it won't show up. That's it. So we are drawing our node itself. We are drawing our tooltip. In future, we have more jobs in here. So I will just stop them in. And where is that? Okay, because I need to do that. And that is draw inputs. And we sent in the event. Then we have our draw outputs. And we send in the event. Then we have draw connections. No, actually, yeah, we have it. But before drawing connections, I want to say draw comment. After draw comment, we have process events that accepts the event. And the view rect, the capital one. And at the end, I will say editor utility dot set dirty this. So any changes that I do on my node schema will go to this. And I need to do one more thing here that I totally forgot. Editor utility dot set dirty. This dot parent, not parent graph, dot related node. Okay, so I want to set the dirty on both related node and the schema so that the related node follows the changes we are making. Okay, so as you see, for at least 5 more episodes, we won't be able to go back into Unity and see what we are doing. Or at least I have to comment these guys one after another and uncomment these as we go forward. Okay. So next episode, of course, we will draw our inputs. Until then, have fun, everyone. Bye-bye.